I think the two use cases are in high demand in the banking industry is the global payment business, the cross-border payment business. And here, I think Ripple is leading the field with over 100 banks in their network. They have already couple of billions of transaction volume last year. And so they're getting a lot of traction because the advantage in the global payment business is significant because today, if you send money cross-border for institutional clients, multiple days, $50 in average cost and operational risk error rate. And with the blockchain technology, you have real-time execution, 7 days, 24 hours. So that's a huge advantage for all the treasury departments of their corporate clients because you can do real-time execution of fund transfer at the end and makes the cash management much easier. Costs will come down, operational risk come down. So there is a significant benefit in doing this. So there is an estimation about $50 to $60 billion cost efficiency only through that. And the second area is you see a lot of new business networks coming up in the area of trade finance. In Europe, there are two already, multiple banks try to simplify the whole business between export, import of goods, synchronizing delivery of goods with the whole initiation of payments. From that perspective, that's another $15 to $16 billion efficiency gain. So those are the two hot cases, use cases that are, I believe this year you will see more banks going into production.
Michael, you operate a bank in Poland. What are you doing with blockchain and how advanced are you, say, versus your rivals?
Yeah, I think first of all, banks have to realize that if they're resistant to technology, you might as well see, and you already see it in the market, two clusters of banks. One cluster from a trading or valuation perspective are, say, the traditional banks that have not yet got disrupted, and other are just technology companies with a banking license. So we as Pekao, we take a view that if the train is coming and if you know you will get hit, you have two options. You can either stand still or get on a train. And if you get on the train, you can be a passenger or you can be the driver. So we want to be the driver in the train. We are investigating blockchain usage. We are the largest corporate bank. We also looking at robotization, automatization of our back offices. Back office, and what we see is first of all, in all custody repo business, I think global, I used to work for a global investment bank. The way you do settlement, the way you do clearing is a 19th century way of settling where, I don't know how many of you are aware, it takes you 3 days until you actually settle. And we are pretty, this is the market standard. We're pretty sure that blockchain will change it dramatically. I think everything related to shared economy, e-commerce is also a potential area where banks will be more and more active because of AI and big data, but also blockchain will be disrupting this area quite a lot. And last but not least, beyond banking, I think insurance will get disrupted. Once you introduce the blockchain database to the you know, land registers, you'll be able to eliminate fraud. You will have more accurate, safe data. So I think insurers should also look very closely at different usages.
Demarco, let's hear from you. You're working with businesses globally to advance blockchain. Where do you think the banks are with the technology as they begin 2018?
Well, just building on Michael's comments a moment ago, I was talking with the head of strategy at one of the world's largest financial institutions recently, and he said that blockchain isn't just an opportunity to think about a specific process. It's a moment when we can reimagine the entire industry and think about what it would look like if we were to build it again from the ground up. Michael and Oliver are absolutely correct. Many of the structures and many of the mechanisms that are in place in the banking sector today are very antiquated. They are not the way that you would design 21st century rails. Blockchain provides us with an opportunity to create new 21st century rails. And in doing so, we could see extraordinary progress across the ecosystem.
Hey there, thanks for checking out CNBC on YouTube. Be sure to subscribe to stay up to date on all of the day's biggest stories. You can also click on any of the videos around me to watch the latest from CNBC. Thanks for watching.